Saturday night, my dad would take sheets and rip them. And then she would sit on one of those old two-step stools that almost everybody had back in the late 40s. And she'd sit there for hours while we wrapped curls through her hair. And she'd be falling asleep, and you'd have to pick her up and wait. And my mother would be over by the iron board, supervising, to make sure that he did it right. And in the morning, we'd get up, and he'd come down, and he'd unwrap those curls. And it was before Slinkies, but it sure looked like she had a whole lot of Slinkies in her hair when she walked. And she was cute as a button. First grade, she became the wife of Tom Thumb. That was her start of her acting career. She and I joined the junior choir, both of us sang. And we would go every Friday night to church for the choir. And then after that, we'd go across the street and walk this long, long, dark road to my cousin's house, Susan Drinkwater. Susan Towns at the time, and they had a 17-inch black and white television, which was the best there was at the time. And we'd watch Howdy Doody and a few other things. I'm sure there were a few of you that may remember that. But Susan was with Les all these last years. On the phone, talking with her, and she basically is another sister to us, both of us. We love her very much, and she helped Lesley a tremendous amount. She and I were in all the operas through high school. We shared leads and that type of thing, so she graduated. Then she went to the University of Hartford, the Hart School of Music, and she basically put herself through college, working nights at Pratt & Whitney, singing. I would go down in the middle of the week, and I was working at the time, so once in a while I could flip a $5 bill to her. Back in those days, she ate for a week on that, you know, that type of thing. Came home, went to work after school. And then she got a little note from my mother who said, I think that you should come back to St. David's and join the choir. She says, well, I'm there for. Well, we have a new organist, and he is cute. And she came back to church, and some of the rest of the story you all know. Just as a little footnote, our priest at the time, John Tyler, well, he was out of Virginia. We had him for a lot of years, and there were a lot of things that he brought to that church. One of them that I'll never forget is you never kiss a girl before you're 30. So I'm assuming that came from this area. He was a great, great, great man. Last night I talked on the phone. It was difficult, but nowhere near like it was the last few weeks. And she can tell you, every time I bumped into her, from the time we were little, and she had the date and the time up here, and she would remind me of it too. As I got up, as she was working at school, or going to school, I was working in the garage, and my mom, when our birthdays came around, there were certain birthday wishes that you had to make. And the one that she wanted me to make was wish for that Cadillac. Well, I eventually got the Cadillac. Came home, and one day she came over and said, Gary, I need to use your car. Okay. Now, of course, being a boy, I'm very proud of the car. It was, you know, life itself at that time. 5 years ago, 6 years ago, it had matured. So that when she sang, I just sat there in awe. I loved her very much. And I loved Lesley very much. And she's laughing at me. I know she's Lesley's all here. She's still laughing. And it's going to be tough without her around, reminding me of all my faults. And good things, too. She was proud of her grandchildren. Oh, my word. I knew, I was just saying to the kids, because we don't get to see them. I know everything about you. You know, I hear. But matching up faces and everything else, it was a little difficult when we first saw the kids. Lesley was a loving mother and a very devoted wife to a very devoted husband. Thank you.
O God of grace and glory, we remember before you today our sister Lesley. We thank you for giving her to us to know and to love as a companion in our pilgrimage on earth. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us your aid so we may see in death the gate to eternal life, that we may continue our course on earth in confidence until, by your call, we are reunited with those who have gone before us. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
You may be seated.
Reading from Proverbs. A capable wife, who can find? She is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. Strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her happy, her husband too, and he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. Charm is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a share in the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the city gates. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The psalm is from Psalm 121. We can read it together. I lift up my eyes to the hills, from where will my help come? My help comes from the Lord, who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. He who keeps Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by the day, nor the moon by night.
Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
You may stand for the reading of the Gospel. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. I am giving you these commands so that you may love one another. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
You may be seated.
Thank you.
Grace and peace to you, friends, from our life and our salvation, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As I began my time here at St. Luke, Lesley's reputation for humor and spontaneity preceded her. Even before she and I first met, I was told a version of the following story at least 6 times by 6 different people. One Sunday, Fred was preaching and began an illustration into one of his pet peeves. He recalled the frustration of opening up a closet door and having a bunch of clutter come tumbling down on him. A few people in the congregation chuckled, but then cutting through it all, suddenly came Lesley's voice from the back. "Oh, get over it." I was told there were many such times when Lesley's well-timed interjections brought such lovely laughter to our church. Which then, of course, makes it an odd juxtaposition to today gathered for the memorial service of one who's so full of life. In our gospel this morning, we hear Jesus speak to the disciples as he bids them farewell. In this moment, shortly before Jesus' death, Jesus' priority is love. We hear in our gospel that God's love for us does not stop in us. It does not end in us. Rather, God's love flows through us as we in turn love one another. And more than serve, Jesus says, we become friends to one another. And so what more beautiful example of such Christ-like love and servant-minded leadership than the love of Lesley and Fred that they showed to one another? 4.5 months ago, on Fred's last Sunday as pastor of St. Luke, many of us recall witnessing something special. At the end of the service, in this very spot in the sanctuary, he and Lesley came forward to renew their vows, to renew the promises they once made to serve each other in sickness and in health, in good times and in bad. It's especially appropriate to recall this moment this morning for 2 reasons. The first is that this renewal of vows is a beautiful illustration of our gospel reading, just kind of plain and simple. It's a beautiful illustration of what we read in our gospel, of Lesley's faithfulness and the love that flowed from God through her into all the lives she touched. But second, speaking of this renewal of vows also touches on something much deeper. Because today, even as we mourn, aren't we also, in a way, gathered here now to witness a renewal of vows? Aren't we here in the end, here witnessing God's renewing of God's vows to Lesley and to us? In this space, the same space just as before, we see before us a renewal of a vow of love, a promise of love, but this time made from God to Lesley. God's vow to Lesley began before she was even aware of it. Washed in the waters of baptism, she was claimed by God, named by God, and made God's own. As she grew older, these promises were renewed in the breaking of bread and wine as she received communion in her community with her people. These promises were celebrated by Lesley again and again in her singing and in her play. As she grew, as she fell in love, God walked with her in good times and bad times, in sickness and in health. God remained faithful, never wavering from these vows of love. Until at last, again, here today, we watch in wonder as God renews this ultimate vow that not even death will separate her from divine love. And this, friends, is a promise both personal and cosmic. A promise made both to Lesley, but also an enduring testament to God's love for all of us from time immemorial. What is our scripture, after all, but an endless and beautiful series of vows being made over and over and over again to us by God? Vows that God renews to us again and again. Vows that God made to Noah to never flood the earth again. Vows to Abraham and Sarah that their descendants would number as the stars. vows to Hagar and Isaac and Jacob that God would protect them and keep them. Vows to Moses in the wilderness that God would set his people free. And it doesn't end there. God keeps promising, keeps vowing to Israel that God will not let them go. In sickness and in health, even as Israel stumbles and falls, even as God's people are marched off to exile and everything seems lost, God keeps promising new life and hope. In this Advent season we find ourselves, we prepare for God's greatest vow yet. A promise for us, a promise that's given flesh and breath in the name of Christ Jesus. A vow that through Jesus' death and resurrection, death has been defeated forever. In Jesus, there is resurrection and new life. We mourn today, and it is good and right to mourn. And we also hold on to this promise that is Jesus. We hold on to this divine vow that death is defeated, that today is renewed in our presence. For neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor power, nor height, nor depth, nor anything in all of creation will ever be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. As we now say goodbye, we have God's assurance that this is not the end. Jesus loves you. Jesus loves Lesley. And so with Easter hope, we gather to witness this renewal. We gather in faith to entrust her to God's care. Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Living together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe
in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended to heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, holy baptism, you have named your chosen people together into one communion of saints in the body of Christ. Give to your whole church in heaven and on earth your light and your peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Grant that all who have been baptized into Christ's death and resurrection may die to sin and rise to share the new life of Christ. Lord, in your mercy. Give courage and faith to all who mourn, assurance and hope in your loving care, that, casting all their sorrow on you, they may have strength for the days ahead. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Grant to us who are still in our pilgrimage and who walk as yet by faith, that, where this world groans in grief and pain, your Holy Spirit may lead us to bear witness to your light and life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Help us, in the midst of things we cannot understand, to believe and trust in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to life everlasting. Lord, in your mercy.
God of all grace, we give you thanks because of his death, our Savior Jesus Christ destroyed the power of death, and by his resurrection he opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. Make us certain that because he lives, we shall live also. That neither death nor life nor things present nor things to come will be able to separate us from your love in Christ Jesus our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord, who brought to life the living hope of a blessed resurrection, that in our grief we may rejoice in full assurance of our change into the likeness of his glory. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, almighty and merciful God. You are most holy, and great is the majesty of your glory. You so loved the world that you gave your only Son, so that everyone who believes in him may not perish but have eternal life. We give you thanks for his coming into the world to fulfill for us your holy will and to accomplish all things for our salvation. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me. For as often as we eat of this bread and drink of this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. Remembering, therefore, his salutary command, his life-giving passion and death, his glorious resurrection and ascension, and the promise of his coming again, we give thanks to you, O Lord God Almighty, not as we ought, but as we are able. We ask you mercifully to accept our praise and thanksgiving, and with your word and Holy Spirit to bless us, your servants, and these your own gifts of bread and wine, so that we and all who share in the body and blood of Christ may be filled with heavenly blessing and grace, and receiving the forgiveness of sin may be formed to live as your holy people, and be given our inheritance with you and your saints. To you, O God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be all honor and glory in your holy church, now and forever.
Amen.
Gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love you have given us a foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that the sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction, and a pledge of our inheritance in that kingdom, where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crying, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Let us commend Lesley to the mercy of God, our Maker and our Redeemer. Into your hands, O most merciful Savior, we commend your servant Lesley. Acknowledge, we humbly beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into this blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious coming